Being human is at the heart of the encyclical, and it's at the heart of what it is to be the church. It's the heart of what Jesus was on about. This is what it is to be human, and human with one another. And that necessarily includes creation in all that it is.
In May 2015, Pope Francis released an encyclical that laid out the Catholic Church's position on climate change and protecting the environment. This single document has received worldwide attention.
As a first of all, it is a game changer, I think. I mean, if you read the encyclical, it's a beautiful document. Of course, it reflects the state of the climate science and so on, the biodiversity research, all these things. But it also has some very, very important, clearly moral and spiritual messages, but it's also pure poetry in parts.
When Pope Francis released the encyclical, Schellnhuber was there at the Vatican explaining the science of climate change. If that sounds like a big deal, that's because it was. Schellnhuber is the first and only person in history to have given a PowerPoint presentation in the Vatican.
So I was invited to give a PowerPoint presentation on the climate issue, and actually I was explicitly asked whether it reflects truly the scientific state of the art, which I could testify, but I also had the chance to send or to give a worldwide assessment of the predicaments we have, the problem we have to solve, how it is related to human equity and all these issues.
One of the arguments against climate action is the assertion that protecting the environment comes at the expense of the poor. But Pope Francis points out that the opposite is true. By helping the environment, we're also helping the poor.
Only by protecting the environment, we can guarantee that the poor will have a somehow decent life and may become a little bit more affluent. And also that this means that the rich have to pay the price for this transformation. Who else? You cannot ask the poor to pay the price. It's absolutely ridiculous to even think about it.
The interaction between helping the poor and helping the environment cuts to the very heart of what drives Pope Francis.
He was choosing the name Francis in reference to Francis of Assisi for two reasons. One is that Francis of Assisi is referring to this empathy we need to have with the weak people, the poor, the old, the young. And the second is the respect for nature, environment, the creation. So this combination, it's a magic combination.
It's not just the Catholic Church that is asking for more effective climate action. People of all faiths are realizing that we have a responsibility to protect our environment. I also spoke to Katherine Hayhoe, a climate scientist who happens to be an evangelical Christian.
I think reminding people that the world around us and the universe around us is what Paul calls a revelation of God to us. It's almost like God's second book to us. So in understanding the way that the universe is put together and the way that our Earth works and the incredible balance that our Earth has that we are disrupting through our carbon emissions, we're understanding what God was thinking when he set it up in the first place.
With the Paris COP21 climate negotiations only a few months away, the Pope's encyclical is an invaluable call to action. By harnessing the energy of over a billion Roman Catholics, he's taking a critical step towards achieving meaningful action on climate change.